Hello, welcome. Today we bring exciting news about the latest stable version of PCSX2, PCSX2 2.0. In this video, we'll explore the many new features this update brings. If you enjoy this type of content, don't forget to leave a like so I can continue producing videos like this. And if it's your first time here, consider subscribing to receive more content like this. It's been over 4 years since the last stable release of PCSX2, and since then, the project has undergone over 6,000 changes. With over 100 million downloads to date, PCSX2 celebrates over 20 years of continuous development. If you've used the emulator recently, you've likely noticed the new interface. PCSX2 has abandoned the old WX widgets interface, which not only had an outdated appearance but also suffered from issues like deadlocks and lack of pre-game customization. The new QD interface marks a new era for PCSX2, providing a modern and intuitive look. Another crucial point that drove the project's evolution was the elimination of plugin usage. For those unfamiliar, plugins are add-ons used for specific functions like graphics, audio, and controls. While they offered the advantage of choice, allowing you to swap a video plugin if a game didn't render correctly, the integration of code from different developers often resulted in errors and issues. In the new era of PCSX2, all these functionalities have been incorporated directly into the emulator's code, eliminating the need to configure plugins individually and ensuring much greater accuracy. Regarding the title I mentioned, PCSX2 has become the best emulator currently available. It's not clickbait. Those who have used earlier versions of PCSX2 know how cumbersome it was to configure each game separately. Speed adjustments, custom graphic options, and fixes for graphic plugins required extensive changes for each title. Today, all of this is a thing of the past. A database has been developed that automatically configures the emulator for each game, ensuring the best possible experience without users needing to manually adjust details. This includes control configuration as well. Whether using a DualShock 3 or another generic controller, PCSX2 adjusts automatically to provide the best gameplay, saving time and significantly improving quality of life. Speaking of accuracy, PCSX2's compatibility has reached an impressive milestone of 99.15% for games listed as playable. In the Nothing category, no games are listed. In the Menu category, only games from the Final Fantasy XI series are present due to their reliance on dedicated online servers. In the In-game category, we find games considered extremely challenging to emulate, either due to their use of complex peripherals or intense visual effects, such as Zone of the Enders the Second Runner. And for those who prefer gaming in front of the TV, PCSX2 hasn't left you out. With the growing popularity of laptops and devices like Android Box and Amazon Fire Stick, PCSX2 introduces the Big Picture mode, similar to Steam's. Through a dedicated button or by setting up a shortcut in PCSX2, you can easily access this mode, start games, create save states, exit games, and return to the emulator's menu, all without having to leave your comfortable couch. With all the evolution we've mentioned so far, some older things had to be left behind, such as support for older operating systems like Windows 7 and 8. We understand that many of you may not like this, but these changes are necessary to further improve the project. Newer operating systems are essential for exclusive features, such as FastMem, which provides a significant performance boost. On the other hand, support for macOS, which had disappeared for a while, has returned permanently this time. The patch and cheat system of PCSX2 has been updated with Natch 2.0. This version brings several improvements for games, such as unit conversion, unlocking 60 FPS in certain games, and general modifications. A new menu has been added to control the system, making it easier to activate or deactivate enhancements and cheats during gameplay. Additionally, improvement patches are now organized in a specific repository, where the community can contribute directly by creating and updating patches, such as widescreen support, interlacing removal, 60 FPS support, and other mentioned in-game enhancements. Another automatic adjustment will be corrections for Gran Turismo series games. It will no longer be necessary to change default settings to maintain game performance, as everything will be automatically fixed by PCSX2. A very significant addition to enhance performance was the implementation of the Vulkan API. This modern API continues to evolve and provides superior performance with fewer stutters across all types of emulators. For those who want to see the real impact, I've left a video in the card and description demonstrating how Vulkan usage can improve performance or reduce GPU usage. Vulkan also offers excellent performance on AMD GPUs, unlike PCSX2's old OpenGL API, which had poor optimization on AMD drivers. Furthermore, Vulkan generally delivers better results than DirectX, which still struggles with certain blending effects. However, it's recommended to leave the renderer in automatic mode, where the emulator prioritizes stability followed by accuracy. Blending is the technique used in PlayStation 2 to combine two graphic layers. If your game features effects like lights, brightness, shadows, transparencies, reflections, or visual overlays, blending is likely involved. The performance of blending effects has been significantly enhanced, contributing greatly to overall graphical performance improvements. Previously, some games required higher precision in blending to emulate certain graphical effects, which could adversely impact performance, especially on older GPUs. With the implemented improvements, basic blending now suffices for many cases across all renderers. The PCSX2 team conducted benchmarks to showcase the FPS increase due to the new blending improvements. Let's now compare the results between version 1.6 and version 2.0 to see the improvements achieved. In Need for Speed Carbon, we observed an incredible performance increase of 1060% when using an internal resolution scaled up by 8 times. In Sly 2, with the internal resolution tripled on an RTX 2070, we achieved a 166% increase. Similarly, in Zone of the Enders, also with the internal resolution tripled on an RTX 2070 Super, the gain was 178%. Even integrated videos, using only the internal resolution, showed a significant increase of 29.9% while running Ratchet Clank 3 on an AMD Ryzen 5 5600X. Gran Turismo 4, with the internal resolution tripled on an RTX 2070 Super, saw a gain of 36.4%. And Baldur's Gate, at its native resolution on the same RTX 2070 Super, had an impressive increase of nearly 514%. Amazing, isn't it? Another recent issue fixed in PCSX2 was the ghosting effect occurring with altered internal resolutions. Over 120 affected games have been corrected for this problem. For those interested, I've included a video in the description and cards to delve deeper into this topic, considering I've mentioned it a few times. Furthermore, the so-called shuffles, an advanced graphics technique used by PS2 games to optimize the GS memory layout and perform complex effects within its limited space, have been significantly improved. These optimizations not only ensured better functioning of these effects with blends but also fixed numerous graphical bugs and brought significant performance improvements along the way. Now you can also capture your gameplay directly from PCSX2 without the need for third-party software. The FEMPEG tool has been integrated into the project, allowing high-quality recordings that support AV1 and hardware capture. To use this feature, you need to download the FEMPEG package from the PCSX2 dependency repository. Another incredible feature that has been implemented is texture replacement. With this feature, you can create your own custom textures or use community-created packs. Alongside resolution scaling, this allows you to transform your old games into impressive visual experiences. A highly anticipated fix has been made to the skies in Criterion Engine games, such as the Burnout and Black series, where an old issue caused skies to render incorrectly, appearing completely dark. This problem has been rectified, so you can now fully enjoy games using the Criterion Engine. The Destroy All Humans franchise games have also received significant improvements. Although they are not yet rendered perfectly, you can now play them without needing software mode for correct rendering. Another common problem that was resolved affected the Ace Combat franchise games, specifically related to the black, textureless fighter jet and general lighting issues. Previously, the only solution was software rendering, but with this new version of PCSX2, you can enjoy the franchise without these problems. For those who, like me, are fans of the golden era of the Need for Speed franchise, the fixes in blending and shuffles have had excellent results here. Now, the game no longer experiences frame drops for no reason, allowing you to enjoy all those lights and reflections without compromising smoothness. In addition, there has been a revamp in audio emulation. Although improvements have been implemented, rarely has anyone complained about sound on PCSX2. For achievement enthusiasts, PCSX2 now supports retro achievements. This community-driven feature already covers over 500 games as of this publication. For those with extensive libraries on their hard drives looking to save space, PCSX2 offers two methods to reduce the size of your collection. The first and most popular is the CHD format. Similar to CSO in terms of performance, CHD supports bin and CUE files based on CDs. Compressing your library into this format eliminates unnecessary files present in ISOs, reducing game sizes by up to half without compromising texture or audio quality. If you're interested, I can create an exclusive tutorial video teaching you how to convert your entire library to this format. For those familiar with using OPL on the original PlayStation 2 hardware, you know that OPL is essentially a launcher for games that don't have working disk drives. OPL allows games to be loaded directly from USB ports, network adapters, and even internal hard drives. In case of large libraries and disk space issues, OPL resorts to the ZISO format. Therefore, if you use the emulator and a real console, this is the format that facilitates migration between devices without the need to re-download your games. Another major advancement in the project was the implementation of automatic update process. In older versions, it was necessary to download a compressed file and extract it over the existing installation, a tedious process that took time. With the new Qt interface, this complication has been eliminated. Updates are now performed automatically. After the user allows the update, the emulator starts in the latest version without further intervention. Speaking as a user since the early days of the project, I've witnessed various phases, including version 1.4, which took a long time to update and seemed abandoned. However, everything changed with versions 1.6 and 1.7. With automatic improvements and compatibility exceeding 99% of games, I can confidently say that PCSX2 is the best emulator available today, surpassing Dolphin, PPSSBP, and even DuckStation. I eagerly await the day when a version of PCSX2 2.0 like this can be ported to mobile devices, such as Android phones. I hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time,